Hello friends, let us now learn some important points about chest compressions. So, chest compressions should be, where do you do chest compressions? They are done mainly in the midline on the lower one third of body of sternum. They are done in the midline of the lower one third of body of sternum, or you can also do them in the midline just below the line joining the two nipples. So if this is the body here, you can do it just in the midline of the line joining the two nipples, or you can do it in the lower border of one third of the sternum. So what are the techniques used for chest compression? The techniques used in the neonate for chest compressions are, we have two thumb encircling technique, which is actually preferred than two finger technique, because why is two thumb encircling technique preferred? Because with two thumb encircling technique, you can develop higher pressures. Higher pressures are generated, and it will also provide better perfusion. And if you see, it will have lesser rescuer fatigability, is also less fatigability. Okay, this is about chest compressions. Then if you see, what is the depth of the chest circumference? It should be one third of the anteroposterior diameter of the chest. Then if you were asked what is the ratio of chest compressions to the positive pressure ventilation which should be maintained, it is 3:1. That is, in 1 second you should give 3 cc of 3 cc should be given, and also you should give one breath. Three chest compressions should be given, and one breath should be given in 2 seconds. In 2 seconds you should give 3 chest compressions, and one breath should be given to the baby. So total in 1 minute you will give 90 chest compressions should be given with 30 breaths to the baby. This is chest compressions. Okay, so this is about the chest compressions. Thank you.